Stan, always a pleasure. Absolute pleasure. Back in the Northeast, but you love the Northeast.
Yes, this is where I started off doing the clubs, actually. I did a little bit in Liverpool, and then an agent said, will you go up to the Northeast? He said, you go up there for 2 weeks, he said, and work every day, which was quite unusual, you know, because, you know, the clubs them days used to be like Thursday, Friday and Saturday. But up in the Northeast, they were big things. Sunday afternoons, you know, you'd probably do the same club. You do the all the men in the afternoon, Sunday afternoon, and at night time, they bring the ladies in. I remember a fella said to me, he says, listen, Stan, he says, I think it was in Harleypool or somewhere. It was by the docks anyway. And he said, listen, Stan, he said, today, he said, you'll be as blue as you like. He said, but tonight, when we bring the ladies in, you don't swear. He said, it's respect. I thought that was brilliant.
Brilliant, but you certainly love it. You've got a great affection with the North East, because I do believe sincerely there's a association there with Liverpool and the North East, isn't there, very much?
Well, it is. We're just across the road, aren't we? We were brought up with our dads being dockers and the seafarers and all that, so a lot of people from all over the world came to Liverpool and to Newcastle and Middlesbrough and places like that and they settled. So we had like a mixture cultures, and Liverpool is like dockers, obviously. Middlesbrough dockers. We were brought up with our dads going out on the ships and to unload the ships and coming back, and all the stories and all the jokes and all that sort of thing. So yeah, Liverpool and the Northeast is pretty like the same people, really, because a little bit of a different accent, but I think we all were brought up in that culture.
We all remember Stan Baldwin. We all talk about the Germans and the gag, and probably the most, you know, which was a massive story that went on for and still is referred back to often, is the night on Desert Corner. Where do you ever look back on that and think, "Ooh, wish I hadn't bothered going there," because that was quite a damaging blow, even though it got you mass publicity. And everybody remembers where they were when that TV show was on, because it was a huge moment, wasn't it?
It was a big moment because it was a live show. Des O'Connor, after that show, they didn't do a live show with them anymore, because it was one of those. It was a groundbreaking program. If you remember, on that night we had Oliver Reed on, and Oliver Reed said he had a tattoo, and he said, where is it? And he said, on me cock. Now, they couldn't edit that out. And then I come on and did the Germans with the f***s. But the funny thing about when I was in the dressing room before with rehearsals, Des says, oh, do that gag. Yeah, it's a great gag. I like that one. You know, the f***s. He said, but be careful. So I don't know what he meant by be careful. It's a joke. I think what happened when we had rehearsal, there was three f***s. I said three f***s. In the skies. But when I got on at past 7 of a night with the live audience, and everybody was, the adrenaline was going, there wasn't three b****s, there was a squadron of the b****s. And the thing was, is that, you know, it's sort of, it was put in the papers, and the television went mad and all that, and it wouldn't happen today. I mean, like 15 years, 20 years later, I'm going down London, and there's these big placards outside Euston Station, meet the f***s. It's a film, and it's being plastered all over London, and yet I got bloody lambasted for saying it, you know. And now it's a thing that it's meet the f***ers and the meet the family of f***ers and all that. It keeps going.
Massive defeat today, because this is a huge occasion. It's the Lobster Festival, which happens here in the Hardwick Hall in Sedgefield, but great place to be today.
Yeah, it is, and it's a massive, massive tent, and I'd like to thank Kel Gaddafi for lending it. There's a few holes in it, like, you know what I mean? A few scuds have gone through it.
So I've got to talk about Liverpool, because that's your passion. It always has been. I mean, I can visualise you now at Wembley Stadium. That must have been fantastic when you were out in front with all the boys and Liverpool in the glory days of,
yeah,
of the
time. And I, you know, sort of, we used to go down to Wembley every year, funny enough, Liverpool in the 60s. With that great teams, and you know, the Kenny Dalglishes and the Souneses and all them, you know, they were all heroes in Liverpool. You know, ever started mentioning Keegan and all them and Toshack. I could go on forever. Yeah, we were great, and I'll never forget. I was down there the time that when we beat Newcastle. Terry McDermott was playing for Newcastle that day, and I think it was 3-0. I must admit, it wasn't sort of any fighting or anything like that. the Scousers and the Newcastle crowd really got on well together. They're all putting their arms around each other and all saying, never mind, mate, you know, it's your turn next year and all that. It was good humour and good fun, you know, not like they are today. Everyone's screaming at each other's throats, aren't they? Like, you know, Man United and City and all them, you know, Arsenal. And so it's like, so, and Chelsea, everybody hates Chelsea.
Tell us about Andy Carroll, obviously from Newcastle. You're one of the famous supporters of Liverpool Football Club. How's he been received? What's the welcome he's received down there? And what's the buzz around the city at the moment for him? And what's the future for him?
Well, we all always thought that he was a good player. And obviously he did a good job for Newcastle. And we had Torres. And Torres, he wasn't doing the job for us at all. £15 million and was on the table. And they thought, well, OK, we'll have that. And we'll get, I think Carroll went for about 26 or so. And that now it proves now that it was a better buy than what we even thought it would be after seeing Torres playing for Chelsea, and he hasn't even scored a goal yet. We were waiting for Carroll to score a goal, funny enough, and we thought, hang on, with a name like Carroll, he might not score till Christmas. And then goes and bangs a couple in the other week. No, but, you know, and now he's in Liverpool, now he's on fire, and so is his car.
Tell us about the reaction to him arriving there. He's got the potential to be massive there, hasn't he?
Well, we've got about three or four players now that have just come town at the same time as Carroll. So they've all been waiting for Carroll to perform. Liverpool will welcome footballers. It's a footballing city. Funny enough, we've got two lads who've just come through from the academy, and they played this week, last week, and they've come through great. Suarez, he's another good player. He's come along and he's linked up well with Carroll. So I think that now that he's got them two goals under the belt, I think now then he can relax now. Whereas, you know, it's like if you haven't scored, I mean, Torres must be going through torment now. As he said, and it'll come back to haunt him. He said, I want to go to a bigger club. Hey, Chelsea, they've only been in the Premier League, well, on the First Division for about 5 or 6, 7 years. They haven't won hardly anything, have they? Whereas Liverpool are the biggest club than Chelsea will ever be.
So any tips you'd give him arriving from Newcastle to Liverpool? You know the city inside out. What tips would you give him?
I think the thing he's got to be very careful of, that he doesn't get into the drinking culture that we have in Liverpool. You know, you could go out in Liverpool and nobody bothers you. Okay, they'll come up and they pat you on the back and say, all right, it's great. You know, it's just like Newcastle and Middlesbrough. They'll come out and all that. But, you know, he's a young lad. He'll have the freedom of the city. He'll have all the women after him. He'll have to watch that, you know, that he keeps out the papers and just have good stuff going in the papers instead of that. And hopefully he doesn't get into any trouble, because there are a few dodgy people about who'll want to try and cause trouble for him. I'm not saying what supporters they'll be, but they won't be Liverpool supporters. So he's just got to sort of have someone to watch his back. It is a great city, Liverpool, and it's a tough city. It's just a matter of sort of going to the right places. Liverpool's getting better and better with the city of culture and the docks all being done up. It's unbelievable. People go from Newcastle and Middlesbrough, go there for a night out. I couldn't believe it. They go for M parties and everything. So, yeah, it's a great, fun city. Just let's hope that he can control it being a 21. You know what we were all like when we were 21. Our world's our oyster, but at the end of the day, he is a professional footballer. He doesn't want to let people down. He's earning good money, and he'll score lots of goals and look after. And you know, he wants to be playing football when he's up to 35. If he can lay off the hospitality, because a lot of hospitality that you will get, people buying your drinks and buying your stuff like that. So he's got to be able to, you know where to stop.
Is there any similarities then between the North East and the nightlife culture? Because Stan, you've been all over the North East, you've worked here many, many years. What's the similarities then?
Well, the funny thing about it, Liverpool and Newcastle, they're like sort of, people like to used to like to go out on a Friday night or a Saturday night. Now it's every night. I remember going to Newcastle and walking down the street and seeing the girls in December and January with mini skirts on and a blouse, and with all, everyone's bloody freezing. And and the buses used to stop at 12 o'clock, and everybody would walk about 5 miles to get home. So you see a procession from the town centre to all the suburbs. Same in Liverpool. It's exactly the same in Liverpool. You see people streaming. I mean, now they're starting to put the buses on late now because kids now go out to Liverpool, don't go out until 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock at night. So it's round the clock drinking, enjoying yourself. And the clubs are fantastic. The wine bars, and they're all policed, and they've all got good bouncers on the door. You hardly get any trouble at all. You know, no, it was like in the 50s and 60s when everyone was fighting in the streets. But now it's all, you know, everyone seems to be looking after themselves.
Ex-Newcastle boss Kenny Dalglish, of course, hero on Merseyside at the Kop, adored him, he's back. Bit iffy, you know, the way the results have gone, bit up, bit down. Is he the man?
Well, yeah, I think so, because I think that the two foreign managers really spoilt Liverpool's, the structure of Liverpool. Liverpool was always like a sort of a family affair. We had the Moors who passed it down from family to family. They had the Liverpool, the way the structure of it was bringing the lads up through the academy and the reserve teams. But as soon as these, especially Benitez, he got rid of all that and wouldn't pick any of the lads out of the, which I think it was stupid, picking anybody from the academy. And that's why Stevie Iwaith packed in, because Stevie Iwaith was boss at the academy. And he said, well, why am I working here when you're not bringing any of my lads through who are good players? From Steven Gerrard and Carragher, then there was nobody came through after them for years, because he used to bring all the Spanish people over. And Liverpool was Spanish run, Spanish players, and there must have been about 30 or 40, 50 players from Spain.
Joke of the day then, Stan?
Joke of the day. Fellow in the pet shop, he said, have you got a wasp? He said, a wasp? We don't sell wasps. He said, there was one in the window yesterday. And joke of the day. What about the British Armed Forces? They're doing a no-fly zone in Libya. About time as well. I went there for my oldies once. It was full of flies.